Hello and welcome to the University Hospital Regensburg and the Regensburg Center for Interventional Immunology. My name is Marina Kreutz. I'm a professor of molecular oncology and also head of a clinical cooperation group immunometabolomics within the RCI. Since many years, my group is interested in the interplay between tumor and immune cell metabolism. Together with my colleagues, Dr. Katrin Renner-Sattler, an expert in mitochondrial physiology, and Dr. Peter Ziska, a clinician scientist, we performed a study and investigated the metabolism of immune cells within COVID-19 patients.
In previous studies, we showed that metabolism of immune cells not only supports, but also regulates the immune response in cancer and autoimmunity. It is currently unclear why some COVID-19 patients develop a highly inflammatory, possibly fatal state. In this study, we asked whether metabolism of T cells and other immune cells in COVID-19 might be dysregulated and if it's possible to intervene pharmacologically. Samples from 87 COVID-19 patients, 6 critically ill non-COVID patients, and 47 controls were collected and processed freshly without cryopreservation. Flow cytometry, electron microscopy, RNA sequencing, in vitro culture, and metabolic assays such as high-resolution respirometry were used to study different immune cell populations, although the focus was laid on T cells.
We detected a highly disturbed metabolic phenotype in T cells of critically ill COVID-19 patients. Healthy T cells display mitochondria with a typical crystal structure, low intracellular levels of reactive oxygen species, and a limited surface expression of basigene. Basigene, also known as M-prim, is a multifunctional protein involved in metabolic regulation, but also discussed in the context of virus entry. In severely ill COVID-19 patients, we observed increased levels of basigene on T cells. Basigene expression can be triggered by alternate phases of hypoxia and normoxia, as frequently observed in severely ill COVID-19 patients. Binding of the viral spike protein to basigene resulted in elevated intracellular reactive oxygen species levels. Furthermore, T cells of severely ill patients showed an accumulation of damaged mitochondria characterized by an increase in size and a vanished crystal structure. However, dexamethasone shown to have beneficial effects on disease progress and mortality reduced basigene expression, ROS levels, and mitochondrial alterations in vivo and in vitro.
Our results shown immune metabolic dysregulation in T cells of COVID-19 patients, which can be mitigated by dexamethasone treatment. As the corona spike protein itself triggers ROS in T cells, we propose that patients with a detectable virus load might benefit from a prolonged dexamethasone treatment. Our results also suggest to include drugs that reduce oxidative stress in COVID-19 therapy.